Welcome back to YouTube Educational Tutors. Hope all of you are well. And today, seeing the thumbnail, you have already known that I am going to upload the video of her degree change. So, before going to the main context, I have to teach all of you some basic things over it. Okay. First of all, that you have to know that which word is called a degree. If you don't know which word is called degree, then you will not be able to solve it. So the adjectives, you know, among the parts of speech, there are one part of speech which is called adjective. All the adjectives are degree, and the adjectives are like good, bad, little, tall, high, great, etc., etc. And all of these words are transformed into comparative degree as well as superlative degree. Just like that, I am now going to write the word good. Hope all of you know the word about good. Good is a word and it is called positive degree. But when you transform it into comparative, then it would be better, good, better, and the third form, which is superlative degree, is best. Okay, so like this, there are so many words in English dictionary, like tall, high, kind, and so on. And when you transform these words into comparative, then you have to add er with these words. Now I am telling, writing tall, and you have to add here er, and in this way you have to form it in comparative degree. Similarly, when you add with this word est, then it would be superlative degree. Tall, est. Similarly, high would be higher, and in the case of superlative degree, it would be highest, and kind would be kinder and kindest. But there is a little difference between these words and the words which have more than one syllable, just as active. When you pronounce this word, then you will find here two syllable, active. Like this, I am going to write another word, beautiful. Beautiful. In this word, you will also find more than one syllable. Okay, beautiful. There are clearly four syllables in this word, beautiful. So when you will transform these two type of words into comparative and superlative degree, then you should not use here er and est. Rather, you have to use here more before it, more, and in the case of superlative degree, you have to use it most before this word, more active, more active, and most active. In the case of beautiful, you have to write here more beautiful and most beautiful. Okay, so this is the first step of degree change. If you do not know about all of these, then you will not be able to transform the transform one positive degree into comparative or comparative into superlative. Okay, so let's get started. The level 2 of degree change. Now I am going to write a sentence of positive degree, and before it you have to learn that there are two types of sentences are found in the case of positive degree. The first one is started with no other, and the second one is started with very few. So I am going to write the first one like this. No other boy is as tall as Rahul. No other boy is as tall as Rahul. When you transform it into comparative degree, then you have to mind it that this degree, which is a tall, with it you have to add ear. But the format of the sentence will be different from it. In the case of comparative degree, we have to use than any other here. Okay, than any other. But the sentence, when I write it in comparative degree, the sentence will be started with the word Rahul, which is at the last portion of the sentence, Rahul. Rahul, you have to begin with this word, with the word which is called noun, and you will find it at the end of the sentence. So Rahul is, and the verb will be the same as you find it in the question. And in the question, you see that the verb is a present form, is, and you have to write in the answer section also is, Rahul is. And in this portion, you have to transform this degree, which is in the question is tall, and here it would be taller. Okay, Rahul is taller, and then than any other. So Rahul is taller than any other. You have to mind all the time whenever you will try to do it. Rahul is taller than any other, and who is Rahul or what is Rahul? Rahul is a boy, that is clear in the question. Rahul is a boy, no other boy is as tall as Rahul. So it is clear that Rahul is a boy. So you have to write after that any other about Rahul. Rahul, boy. So the answer is in comparatively is Rahul is taller than any other boy. When you transform it into superlative degree then you have to write first of all, or in the very beginning of the sentence, the subject which you will find in the question, and the subject is Rahul. Rahul is the subject. So Rahul is, similarly the verb, whatever you will find the verb in the questions, you have to write in the answer section, Rahul is. And the most important thing here is that you have to use the, Rahul is the, and after that you have to transform tall into superlative degree. Tall, the superlative degree of tall or taller is tallest, as there is only one syllable in the word tall. Rahul is the, so first write tall and then add with it est. Rahul is the tallest, and who or what is Rahul? You will find it clearly in the question that Rahul is a boy, and at the end of the sentence you have to write about the subject. About the subject means Rahul, and Rahul is a boy. So the answer is Rahul is the tallest boy. In this way, dear students, in this way you can easily transform a positive degree into a comparative and a superlative one. Okay, so hope you will better understand after watching the full video, and that is why thanks you all.